as a way to individually adjust the channels here. And as far as the noise,
I got another dollar. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Mizzou Arena in Norm Stewart Court for the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. Fans, players, and coaches alike, get ready for 22 games in over 44 hours of the finest men's and women's high school basketball from across the country, all right here in Mizzou Arena. The 2022 Norm Stewart Classic wants to thank our sponsors for their commitment to this great shootout, including Nestle Purina, M-Pix, Ameren Missouri, Veterans United, Universities, Johnston Paint, Stony Creek, Moex, Columbia Sports Division, D. Rose, Missouri Rural Electric Cooperative, Parker Miller, Sporting KC, Red Weir, and the Parks Recreation and Sport, Pepsi, and ESPN Sports. And just a reminder, all games of the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic can be seen live nationwide and around the world on our website, normstewart.org. Select games can be found on the Stadium Media Network and MediaCom and select markets. The Norm Stewart Classic, a world-class event, right here in Columbia, Missouri.
And when I heard Well, the 6 a.m. match of the Norm Stewart Classic brings us to a matchup between Quest Charter and Kaufman as they welcome you inside of Mizzou Arena in Como. James Stanley with Cam Thomas. And Cam, there's four seniors in this game, and we're going to highlight them here for you in just a moment. But so far, it's been a great Norm Stewart Classic in 2000.
Yeah, well, the overnight games are always the most interesting ones. And I think, you know, one of the things that we see is that it's tough for some of these teams to get up and get going, but it's easier to do that when you've got some senior leadership and some guys that know how to play in big moments and big stages. And that's what we've seen in some of these overnight games. And that's what we expect to see between Quest and Kaufman.
Yeah, I think we're over the hump now. The 4 a.m. game always seems to be the hardest one. But as we look at these seniors first for the Quest Charter Gators, Sean Lewis and John Terrius Sims. And then on the night side will be Jenkins and Mallet. But here's a look at the results from the overnight shift. If you just now joined us, you saw Principia defeat Christian 55-23. Pembroke defeated Kankakee 58-38. And Cardinal Ritter had a very close game with New Madrid County Central 50-49, just a one-point game. And then you go into yesterday, Bishop Miege taking down Webster Groves on the boys' side by 19, and Rockbridge defeating Green Valley 51-46, and they're really trying to rebound and gain back some pride here as they were licking their wounds into this last week because they lost a battle for the first time in program history.
Yeah, and that's something that, you know, hasn't been the norm here in Columbia. You know, Dustin Young and the Battle Spartans have done such a great job. And Jill Nagel's got, you know, some competition in Como now.
And it's just incredible to see what Dustin Young has been able to do with blowing out some of his opponents. It's absolutely ridiculous. And they played in the Sophie Cunningham Classic a couple weeks ago, and that's why they are not in the Norm Stewart Classic this season. And of course, it's great to see how the Norm Stewart Classic has expanded. But the Kaufman Knights are taking the floor. There you see the Quest Charter Gators with their pink jerseys. In order for cancer awareness. And there's head coach Deron Wilson. The Knights enter the game 5-3. And you talk about another icon that did, you know, so much for charity in Kansas City, Ewing Kaufman, where Kaufman Stadium got its namesake. Now for the Kaufman Knights. Cam's a Cardinals fan, so I don't think he likes.
Who knows how long Kaufman Stadium's going to stay in the location that it's in now.
Very true, and the opening tip is taken by the Knights. Gators try to trap a little dish off to Assam. Offensive rebound, and eventually off the hands of a Gator. This will be Kaufman basketball. Lewis and Sims both out on the floor. Those are the two seniors for Quest Charter. We'll keep tabs on tonight, and the rebound goes to Craven Bailey. Cam, just opening notes here, taking a look at the size mismatch that could play a factor into the games in this morning, really.
Yeah, I think, you know, if you look at it on paper, obviously Kaufman has some of the advantage from the inside, but I think from a guard perspective, you could see Quest have an opportunity to really exploit.
Well, Jaden Jenkins sinks the rainbow floater. Now response, what a three from Jontarius Sims. He gets his team on the board early.
Yeah, that's a nice pop and stop three from Jontarius.
Assam can't answer. And last touched by the Knights.
It seems like Ron Ingram wants to have a conversation early. And you know, one of the things that hurts sometimes is that you come out into one of these early games and you see a couple of shots that don't go down that you'd like to go down, and that forces you to have a conversation and realign. I mean, look, a lot of folks see basketball games like this but don't realize how quickly 8 minutes rolls by.
Well, the Knights this year have played a team from mid-Missouri. Was Jefferson City High School. The Jays blew them out in the second half. They won 78-48 last week. And really was the Jays' defense that stopped the Knights from making a comeback. Derek McGee was the leading scorer. He had 13 points. And this short two will be boarded by Jones. He lost it. And a little flat footer stopped by McClendon. Here comes Kaufman. Well, McGee had the right idea, but too many defensive hands in his face. And both sides just trading punches on the boards.
I like the spacing from Kaufman early. It should allow them to open up the perimeter a little bit and be able to knock down some long-range shots.
Well, they've yet to hit a three. And still trying to gauge the depth behind the basket. Breakaway. Bailey to the rack.
Yeah, that's a nice job by Bailey. Leaking out, finding a way to use his athleticism to go up at the rim.
Bailey with the board, leaks it ahead to Lewis. In the post, oh, what a block.
And that's where we talked about the size being an advantage. Rim protectors swarming around.
Gators sent in a pair of subs. And right now the Gators stack in the post low on the 2-3 zone. And right back into the game comes Craven Bailey. Bailey at 6'3", has some of the best size on the Gators.
These teams should have an opportunity to recollect at the under four, James. I think they've been trying to get into some things offensively, but, you know, really haven't been able to establish consistency on either end.
Jordan bounces over to Sims. With Travis Corey. Oh, got blocked, and that's block number two for Jenkins. Harvey, strong to the rim, and gets some help there from Quentin Jones. Count the bucket and one. Well, here we go. We head to break. West Charter up by one. Back with more from the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic right after this.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
We're all in the game in the fight against cancer.
Now we need you on the team.
With you, we will save more lives.
You don't have to be a coach to join Coaches versus Cancer.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy!
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes!
Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
They'll join our team in the fight against cancer. Coaches versus Cancer, part of the Norm Stewart Classic here in Columbia, Missouri. James Stanley alongside Camp Thomas this morning. Hope you got your coffee in the pot, maybe coffee in your mug, as you enjoy some high school hoops. 48 hours of action from the namesake of the legendary Mizzou basketball head coach. So we do have an extra point attempt from Quentin Jones. And the extra point, no good. He'll put up the three and splash down for Sean Lewis. The wind at his back, Lewis, 5 points over a 30-second burst. Cam, no one was going to contest him all the way to the rim.
No, and you know, one thing that he did was get the leak out, but use his speed to find a way to create separation.
How about the response there? Jaden Hassam cuts the lead in half.
Yeah, great job by Hassam, just seeing an opening on that right side and popping up for three.
Harvey, so pesky. Man, he's about a head short. Everyone else on the floor, Cam, but
yeah, they got it listed at 5'9". Take about 4 inches off of that. I think he's probably about 5'5", but he's feisty.
Same with Hassam. He looks feisty as well. The guard play is going to be big here for Kaufman. And they're relying down low on the rebound. So far, Quentin Jones has done a pretty good job. 4-0 run here for Kaufman. Rather a 5-0 run. And the Gators respond as they drop it down the rack. McClendon's first points tonight. Lewis, stop, pop, it caroms out. The tip and a board pulled down by Jones. Full speed ahead to Hassam. And he couldn't finish. Got some hands in his face there from Lewis.
Oh.
Little stop, drop. Oh, it goes.
Oh, that's a nice finish.
Count the bucket. And to the free throw line will head Craven Bailey.
You know what's so interesting about this Quest charter team is that, you know, they only have a couple of seniors that they utilize. And I think it's interesting that Craven, being a sophomore, you know, kind of plays a little bit of a stretch three, stretch four. He's got some length to him at 6'3", but he finds a way to use his length inside, and I think that's what you saw in that last play.
There's a cutter and a splash. And for Marquand Haslip.
Oh, nice kick out. Should give him an opportunity for a bucket.
Well, he got a wedgie.
Now, you know, we saw in this the last game, the 4 a.m. game, that putting the ball in the net was kind of tough in the first quarter. Not so much here in this ball game. Both these teams have seen success shooting the ball, but they've also seen success towards the rim.
Now, this one's close so far, and a nifty move. Hassam. Oh, my. No help. And Kaufman left 2 points on the table. Jump ball. And Kaufman has a chance to have the final say of the first quarter. Trip. And a foul. Well, Cam is 1.5 seconds, enough time to draw something up.
Yeah, well, that actually might have helped him a little bit getting a foul, because now you can inbound.
Turnaround three-pointer. Buzzer beater is well short as we head to break at the end of quarter number one. Quest Charter leads by 4. Back with more at the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic in Como after this.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes!
Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
Woo! Norm Stewart here, former basketball coach, University of Missouri. When you have a good player, you know you're going to have success. When you have a player that is also a leader, then what you try to do is just stay out of the way, and you really will be successful. That's what happened when Warner Baxter came into the fold and started with Coaches Versus Cancer. From that, we went on to CEOs Versus Cancer. What a great ride it's been, and how many people he has helped along the way. I want to congratulate the St. Louis chapter of the American Cancer Society. All your help and the corporate leadership in that area has been tremendous. You've helped so many people. I think all of us always wonder, what can we do? It's very easy. Just do what you can do.
Well, so far everyone is up and at them this Saturday morning for the 6 a.m. match between Quest Charter and Kaufman. A four-point advantage for the Gators so far. James Stanley alongside Cam Thomas. Cam looking at the stats here in the first quarter. Quest Charter shot 46% from the floor compared to a 5-for-19 clip for Kaufman.
Well, one of the things that we're seeing from Quest is that, you know, Lewis is doing a good job of finding his way to the rim for rebounds. I think you need to see some more production from a points perspective throughout the board. Kaufman's finding the edge early.
Mizzou Arena, the site of this one. And the Norm Stewart Classic has grown so much from its early days at Columbia College. And a drive with Bailey getting fouled. He'll go back to the free throw line.
Bailey's found his way to get to the free throw line a couple times here early, and you know he's going to be a key part of this Quest offense. We'll see how they utilize the guard play. But the youngins here early showing that they can hang with the big boys.
Bailey misses on the second. Well, Cam, I don't know if we could talk about Quest Charter without talking about their postseason game last year that went into seven overtimes.
Wow.
And what's even worse is beyond playing seven overtimes is being on the receiving end of a loss of seven overtimes. Tied for the seventh longest game in Illinois high school history. They lost 88-83 to Woodhull Ridgewood. Semifinals of the Class 1A Wethersfield Regional. Oh, good work and a good block.
Well, you hope that Quincy Jones is all right. He tried to block this on the back end, as you'll see him leak out on the backside and fell awkwardly on that left leg, so hope that he's okay.
Well, seems to be all right with getting the rebound. The Knights look to push here. And another foul tabbed on the Gators.
Interested to see if Kaufman can try to close the gap here.
The drive and go floater by Mallett is down the cup. Now just a 3-point game. The bodies flying on the hardwood and will be Quest Charter basketball.
Well, James, this is where the intensity, you know, should start to pick up. You know, it's an early morning game, but, you know, both these teams kind of had a little bit of a lackluster start in the first couple of minutes. I think now what you're seeing is a little bit more focus and a little bit more run and gun style as Kaufman tries to push it quickly the other way.
Harvey kicks it out. A little stop and drop. No offensive rebound. Ripped away and flipped up ahead, looking like Patrick Mahomes on the pass. Here's the drive and lost out of bounds.
You know, some people might not like that shot from Whitley, that pull-up 13-footer from right inside three-point line. But I did like it because it's in the groove of the offense, and it works in that moment. They needed a bucket. I like to see Kaufman work off the dribble a little bit more because the penetration drive just hasn't been there.
Kaufman's done a decent job forcing turnovers. They're plus one on the morning so far. Drive to the rim, Mallett for two. And just like that, Kaufman now trails by one.
Well, that's exactly what they needed to do. You know, the drive penetration hadn't been working, but if you get a leak out and you got an opportunity to go two on one, you might as well.
once on the deck, but it's poked away. Cam, it's been a fun morning of basketball so far. And so far, out of the first game, not sure if we're going to have one that's maybe as close or exciting, although this one's living up to its potential.
Well, yeah, I mean, being a one-point game, you know, between two unfamiliar teams, I mean, it's hard to do, like, to do a scout or anything like that before, because it's not like you've got a kind of ton of contacts from Peoria, Illinois, to Kansas City, Missouri. I mean, it might have been easier for Quest to do some scout on Kaufman than it was vice versa.
Reverse layup is blocked. McClendon with good awareness along the baseline.
Great communication on the defensive side of the ball for Kaufman. They're packing it into a zone here, but at every turn, they're conversing. They're hitting their assignments and making sure that each man is marked.
It's a 4-1 run for the Knights. Good swing to Sims. And I love the elevation there from Mallet. Just comes in at 5'11", but makes up for it. Just ability to get up and not be afraid to go toe-to-toe with some of these guys that are 6 foot plus. Good control there by McGee. Kick it out. Assam. Unselfish basketball, and it almost turns into loss of possession.
Yeah, you can't stay deep on that pass if you're Jones. You got to roll up topside and front face the defender so that you don't get locked in behind the block.
Well, let's head to break. One score game as the second quarter comes to a close at the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
We're all in the game in the fight against cancer.
Now we need you on the team.
With you, we will save more lives.
You don't have to be a coach to join Coaches versus Cancer.
American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy!
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes! Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
Woo! There's Deron Wilson, the head coach of the Kaufman Knights. They're 5-3. Get your early bird special underway for the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. Up next will be Plattsburgh versus Dixon and the boys. All the boys the rest of the morning. Battle versus Oak Park from Kansas City. Hickman versus Chaminade and Rockbridge versus Peoria Notre Dame. Jim Scanlon's crew from the south side of Como looks to get a W here at the Norm Stewart Classic.
It's going to be nice to have another Columbia Mo team, but I'll tell you what, I'm interested to see Cray Logan's Hickman squad play at noon later today.
Oh, they looked unbelievable against Capital City earlier this week. There's a drive and kiss off the glass for Quincy Jones. Kaufman has the lead. I believe for the first time tonight, or this morning. Jordan, indecisive, now works it out to Burroughs. What Kaufman is lacking in size, they have made up for it, Cam, with energy.
Yeah, and they've really done a good job of playing well defensively. That time they just didn't close out well on Lewis. He was able to get the jumper from the left wing to go off the bounce, and he's got a pretty stroke from the left hand.
That was Lewis on the pair. Wide open Trey McGee on the floor. Oh, good find. Sims, it's a foot race, and he's blocked and fouled as they'll tab it on Darian Mallett.
Yeah, Sean Lewis, look at this. I mean, he just gets an opportunity to get on the floor, gets dirty, and passes up ahead, and nice job by Sims to finish it.
And the first free throw misses.
I think it's interesting when you pay attention to the referees, Zach Goody, Paul Malter, to name a few. I mean, these guys, they do a great job, especially during these overnight games. A lot of people think they go unnoticed, and they don't. We see the good work that they do.
Oh, great defense. Burroughs picks it off, drives with the right hand, and back-to-back fouls called on Mallett. That makes two personals on Mallett. And that's one of the disadvantages for the size mismatch.
Yeah.
That's about all you can do to make up for it defensively.
Or hope they miss their free throws when they do get to the line, because you have to foul them because of that size advantage. Because sometimes you do have to do that, right? Like sometimes you have a clear size advantage and your younger guys are just going to have to foul. They may have to rack up a couple here, a couple there, but you want to minimize that as much as possible.
Good spin there from Amir Burroughs. Good dish. Good floater. Jalen King gets on the board.
Oh, nice poke away. Tried to save it on the end line there, but great job of keeping possession if you're Kaufman. Every possession matters.
Rebound, the putback. Quentin Jones knocks it through. With 47 seconds to go in the first half. Take a look here at the rebound. Just such grace. Looks like the shot maybe was blocked.
Yeah, somebody might have got a piece of it in there. There's a lot of hands getting sticky on the interior. And, you know, that's what you want to see from a squad that has had some struggles in this game, but they've done a better job here towards the end of the second half of finding an identity offensively and defensively, closing out on their defenders and playing team defense.
Love to see the support there for Quest Charter coming all the way in from Peoria, Illinois. They got some support there for Davian McClendon. I love the warm-ups, Kim. In this family, no one fights alone. Of course, going on with the theme of the pink jerseys. pink camo, really, for Coaches Versus Cancer. That's what the Norm Stewart Classic's all about raising awareness, raising funds for cancer research.
Well, and they've done such a great job of making this a destination tournament, and they do, and the different schools do their own campaigns at their schools, and I think what I like the most is you get a chance to see the hard work that the students have put in by presenting some of the checks here and, you know, giving it a feel of compassion to go with basketball.
In a close game, I think Quest is all right with running down the clock, although you can't turn it over.
No, you can't do that. You've got to be smart with the possession and keep the basketball, and you know, you got to make smart decisions, smart passes.
Picked up by McGee. 6 seconds to shoot with four. McGee sees the clock with three. He makes his move. Dishes down low. Buzzer beater good. Quest Charter will trail by three at the break on a sneaky move from McKee to Jones. How about that to close off the first half? An exciting matchup we got this morning as we take a look at the highlight and head to break. Back with more from Como right after this at the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic.
American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Norm Stewart here, former basketball coach, University of Missouri. When you have a good player, you know you're going to have success. When you have a player that is also a leader, then what you try to do is just stay out of the way. And you really will be successful. That's what happened when Warner Baxter came into the fold and started with Coaches Versus Cancer. From that, we went on to CEOs Versus Cancer. What a great ride it's been, and how many people he has helped along the way. I want to congratulate the St. Louis chapter of the American Cancer Society. All your help and the corporate leadership in that area has been tremendous. You've helped so many people. I think all of us always wonder, what can we do? It's very easy. Just do what you can do.
Halftime of the 6 a.m. match, the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. James Stanley alongside Cam Thomas. Kaufman leads by three. Cam, what a finish for the first half of the Knights, and it looked like at first we were going to see Quest run away with it, but Kaufman was pesky. They're mismatched, they're mis-sized, but they're hanging in there.
Yeah, and I think one of the things that we liked in the first half was that, you know, Quest went on a little run, they started to extend it a little bit, but then Kaufman started to claw their way back, and, you know, they utilized the boards really well to both these teams. You saw them even in the category in the first half, but I think where you saw the advantage was Quest crashing the defensive glass and getting a little bit more of an advantage there. And look, they've got some strength, but I think Kaufman can still go pound for pound with them. You know, I was astounded to see how much Kaufman gave up the ball, or rather Quest gave up the ball, six turnovers in that first half. So, you know, that's not what you want to see.
Yeah, looking at the rebounds, evenly matched there, but we'll see how it hangs on throughout the rest of the game. We got more highlights, halftime stats coming up next here at the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic from Columbia, back in just a moment.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Infinity and beyond!
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Sponsored by your local law enforcement.
Yes!
Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State. So grab your family and friends and boogie on down to a plunge near you.
It's time to get freezing for a reason. Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
Woo! To find out how you can get involved, visit somo.org/plunge.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
We're all in the game in the fight against cancer.
Now we need you on the team.
With you, we will save more lives.
You don't have to be a coach to join Coaches versus Cancer.
Welcome back to the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. Kaufman leads it by 3 over Quest Charter. We have plenty more games to come on throughout the rest of the morning. Here's a look at the first half highlights. They might be small, but they're pesky, they're mighty. And Cam, so far, they've done a good job defensively keeping toe-to-toe here with Quest Charter.
Well, they know how to flex their muscles, and it's easy to do that when you have some guys that can get out and transition and play with some patience and tempo. I think one thing that you see from Quest is that they've relied a lot on getting the ball in the paint. I think Kaufman's done something a little bit differently where they've mixed up some of the three and also used some of the leak out drives to create some offensive production. One of the things that you want to see a little bit more out of is Kaufman's got to get to the free throw line. One free throw is just not enough in a half of basketball, especially against a team like Quest that's going to try to, you know, scratch and claw at you to get back. They're okay in the rebounding category. I think both teams are crashing the glass a little bit. I think where one issue of concern may be is Quest giving the ball up too much. Are they giving away too many turnovers?
Yeah, absolutely. And what two things that stand out here. One is the free throws for Quest. They're down by three, and they've missed three, and they've shot the ball better from downtown. So if those two things, well, if one of them changes, really the three-point shooting is about as good as it's going to get for any team here at the Norm Stewart Classic. But if the free throws can be made up, well, they got a chance here to overcome this three-point deficit. But a very close game. Looks like we got bookends. We had a close one to start out at midnight. It was a good one, and now we got a good one so far, maybe on the morning nightcap. We'll be back in a couple minutes. You're watching the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. Second half coming up from Como after this break.
American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Norm Stewart here, former basketball coach, University of Missouri. When you have a good player, you know you're going to have success. When you have a player that is also a leader, then what you try to do is just stay out of the way. And you really will be successful. That's what happened when Warner Baxter came into the fold and started with Coaches versus Cancer. From that, we went on to CEO versus Cancer. What a great ride it's been, and how many people he has helped along the way. I want to congratulate the St. Louis chapter of the American Cancer Society. All your help and the corporate leadership in that area has been tremendous. You've helped so many people. I think all of us always wonder, what can we do? It's very easy. Just do what you can do.
Welcome Welcome back to Norm Stewart Court. James Stanley alongside Cam Thomas. Kaufman is up by three. They're getting set for the second half, taking the warm-up shots. Quest has yet to retake the floor, Cam, and we've seen a couple coaches have the same approach, keeping their guys in the locker room until about 30 seconds. They don't want them to take any shots, but with the depth perception, the range behind the basket making a big difference from a transition from a high school gym, is that the smartest decision?
Well, I don't know if it's that much of an issue with two teams like this that have run and gun so much. I mean, these guys get up and down the floor, and they shoot the ball a little bit, but I think one of the things that both of them like to do is get into the rim and finishing through contact. And you can't really teach that in a warm-up setting, so you got to finish it through contact in practice and through games. You got to get out and transition, you know, through seals and things of that nature. So, I'm not all that concerned that, these guys are not coming out to get shots up before, because both of them are defensively minded.
Yeah, absolutely. And I see if they can battle back here, the Gators and the Knights are getting set for the second half. Cam, one thing I think you're going to have to change, though, is that three-point shooting for Kaufman. They could really socially distance themselves in the lead just as long as they can shoot better from three. Their only three-point shot made by Jaden Hassam, who was 1-for-3 from beyond the arc in this one.
Yeah, they really could. And creating separation, you know, it's one of those things that you've got to find something that only you can do. And I think they do have the advantage in shooting the long-range jumper. So if they can find some ways to be creative and maybe bump off screens or use some cutting action to get guys open, that might be useful. It all comes from a play design perspective. Unless you want guys to work in transition and pull up for threes, it's got to be something that's in the half court that is called out, that can develop a little bit, and then you have an opportunity to walk into them. But you don't want to force them.
So Kaufman will have the ball to start it out. Up by three, they had a buzzer beater, and how about a buzzer starter? A little knuckle bobber there in for Derek McGee.
Well, it doesn't hurt for McGee to have to kick it. I like the way that he shot that and, you know, rained downtown. Oh, look at him get in transition. Wow. That's a good backdoor feed. McGee finding Scholes on the backside, and that's not easy to do. You know, when you drive and find a backdoor cutter with as much length as he does, it's tough not to give him the number one option.
Ernest, guys, Ernest.
Oh, good find. Wait for cars to clear. And a little insurance policy good there for a pair. Quest Charter trails by six. Just got to chip away. How about that? Four quick points. And Quest Charter changing something defensively, and it's starting to work.
Yeah, they're starting to go into a little bit more of a man. They packed it into his zone the entire first half, and I think, you know, seeing some matchup issues, it may be easier to mark up.
Bailey drives through traffic. Might be rush hour, but there's a roadblock up ahead. And we'll go back and forth with Gators on a run and Kaufman trying to stop the bleeding.
Oh, good flash. You got to finish those, though.
And how about the finish there?
Yeah, but when you're open, when you're open at that free throw line extended and you have a flash like that middle, if you're big, you don't necessarily have to shoot that shot if you don't think it's a good one. Take a power dribble and float your way inside.
In his defense, though, all it takes is just a millisecond of taking your eyes off the rim if you get distracted by what's behind it, or really the lack of what's behind it.
It does.
And there's a good response. 5 points quickly from Hassam. Kaufman widens the lead, but West Charter's hanging in there. A roar and a good answer. That last 2 point bucket by Quinton Jones.
Yeah, he's just playing his role tonight. I think Jones has done a really good job of, you know, being that fourth man and finding a way.
Kaufman by 9, approaching the media timeout of the third. Right elbow. Oh, better to be lucky than good sometimes, but if your name is Jaden Jenkins, I think you're both.
That's just a nice little fadeaway from Jenkins. Didn't try to do too much. Just saw an opening and pulled up.
In the traffic. Oh, Jenkins. Got on the way. Now it's a caravan for the Knights. And a timeout on the floor. Kaufman driving a wedge in the lead as they're up by 13. Cam, look at the break here. It's three Knights versus, well, three Gators, but my money's on the guys with the swords.
Well, you've got to like the vision from Haslam to drop off to the gunner at the side there and getting down that right alley and finishing the deuce. I mean, that's exactly what you want to see. You know, I like the fact that the guard play has been so active. They've been keen with their hands, and they're not afraid to push. I think that's one of the best things that we've seen is that, you know, these guys, they're not very big, you know, but they are feisty, and they're not afraid to work through contact at all.
Well, he tried to cherry pick with Bailey. He gets stuffed.
Yeah, I don't think Kaufman knew what side of the floor the ball was being inbounded on.
Yeah, twice. Now, it's just been a game of centimeters with the finger roll.
Seems to always be that way, especially with the finger roll.
Everything's going the way of the Knights right now as they continue to widen it. And they'll get a foul down low, whistle blown on Quinton Jones. And now we head to the media timeout. 3 minutes and 33 seconds left in the third. Back with more from Como right after this. It's the Knights up big over the Gators in the Norm Stewart Classic.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Sponsored by your local law enforcement.
Yes!
Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State. So grab your family and friends and boogie on down to a plunge near you.
It's time to get freezing for a reason. Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
To find out how you can get involved, visit somo.org/plunge.
The The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us. Participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
...26-41, the Quest Charter Gators trail here to Queen Coffin Knights. James Stanley with Cam Thomas out of the media timeout, and Clendon will be at the line to shoot a free throw or two.
Well, I couldn't say that welcome back three times fast. Look, this is an opportunity here for Quest at the free throw line to find a way to close the gap. You know, they haven't found much success in the transition game. They haven't found, you know, really much in the half court sets either. So I think if they can force this game to be a little bit more physical down the stretch, maybe they'll find some success at the free throw line, and that can get them within striking distance.
That was a good recovery by McClendon, and see head coach Ron Ingram trying to preach some defense to his team as time is winding down. And Kaufman, just great ball movement. That's what has really helped them create this lead. No contact, no foul.
Yeah, that's a good no
travel.
Call. Great no call.
At the least, you think there might be a jump ball, but a freebie for Quest, although they just give it right back. Sam with McGee. As McGee will slow things down, draw a couple defenders. Now a stop, a pop for Jenkins, and it drops out of the rack.
Oh, Jenkins nice cut.
Gets another chance, and he makes the most of the opportunity off the dish from Jones.
Yeah, that's a nice cut. When you see off a miss, a streaker down the middle of the lane, and you find him like that, great opportunity to pull up.
And a baseline jumper drilled by Burroughs.
Oh, look at this full court pressure. Got to get back, though.
That seems to be no problem for Kaufman. This says a lot here, though, about head coach Deron Wilson, what he's been able to make out of his team's disadvantage in size. He's made up for with ball handling drills in practice. This might be one of the best ball handling teams we've seen of the whole classic. And now we get an and one foul called low by Jones.
Yeah, and I think when the guards lead, that gives you an opportunity to see a little bit more success on the defensive end.
Oh, that was a very close play, but I think Jones, even though he had his feet set, was there just a little too early.
And at some point, these free throws have got to start coming down for Quest.
Well, Sims went 2 for 2 a moment ago. And the extra point is good, so Sims with 5 points in the quarter. Kaufman's still up by 12. Drive low. Another deuce for Quinton Jones. Another part of the game plan here for Kaufman was just build a lead. Kind of like saving acorns for spring. Get a good stockpile. And just as long as you have one left by the time the clock hits zero, that's all that matters.
Oh, a nice break from Kaufman.
Uh-oh. Oh, rare miscue. Sims to the rack. And the Deuce drops in.
Look, if you give these guys opportunities, they will take them. They will take them and run with them. Kaufman's got to do a better job of working better.
Alley-oop in the jam. Raise the roof for Quentin Jones. He's having a big third quarter.
That's what I'm talking about, working better together. When you see an opportunity to fly high, go ahead and send it up to your big man and let him do some work.
Hassan in the post off the block. A foul called against the Knights. Almost stolen away. Now it is Hassan. Is he a track star as well as he evades the block? Good decision by Harvey to back it out. And Kaufman takes a timeout. Kaufman leading by 14. Again, let's take a look at some of those individual numbers. Or rather, let's take a look at this jam. We've only seen two successful jams in the overnight games. Great elevation there by Quentin Jones and great vision by Davion Harvey.
Well, I really like what Quentin Jones has done, especially here in the second half. He has established himself as a guy that can not only work at the block, but can come outside the perimeter and drive. And I think that's important because you don't have driving kick bigs all the time, and he does a really good job of doing both. So I've been very pleased with his play today.
So 30.1 seconds. Kaufman can hold for the final shot. That's some big highlights. They had the dunk, the buzzer beater at the end of the half. And it didn't seem like a lot at the time, but 3-point lead when you were trailing, and maybe the defense for the Gators is going to come alive. Baseball pass up ahead. They turn it back over. It's just not in the groove of the offense.
Yes, sir.
And this team looks completely different than how they looked in the opening 2 minutes. Maybe the 6 a.m. start time is starting to get to them.
Well, the opening told us it was going to be all Quest Charter, and then here comes Kaufman clawing and finding their way back. And, you know, once they took the lead in this third quarter, they haven't really given it up.
And when we were watching them in the warm-ups, Cam, you're thinking, my goodness, it's a big size mismatch. And it looked like the Gators were going to dominate the entire way. Now, there's still plenty of time left. You got to make free throws here if you're McGee, but Kaufman, I think, has been one of the more impressive teams we've seen here at the Classic.
Yeah, we talked about it, you know, in the pregame. We felt that Kaufman was going to have a little bit more of that advantage, but not today.
Well, there's a miscue to end the third. We head to the fourth when we return from Columbia. Back in a moment at the Norm Stewart Classic right after this.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Norm Stewart here, former basketball coach, University of Missouri. When you have a good player, you know you're going to have success. When you have a player that is also a leader, then what you try to do is just stay out of the way, and you really will be successful. That's what happened when Warner Baxter came into the fold and started with Coaches Versus Cancer. From that, we went on to CEOs Versus Cancer. What a great ride it's been, and how many people he has helped along the way. I want to congratulate the St. Louis chapter of the American Cancer Society. All your help and the corporate leadership in that area has been tremendous. You've helped so many people. I think all of us always wonder, what can we do? It's very easy. Just do what you can do.
Let's start the fourth quarter here as we join our teams in the fight against cancer. 2022 Norm Stewart Classic, part of the Coaches versus Cancer campaign. We're glad to have you here with us this Saturday morning in mid-Missouri. Maybe you got your coffee in the carafe, or I guess in the pot. Maybe you're old school, you got it in the kettle. Or maybe you're just now waking up, and this has been a fun one so far. I mean, Kaufman Charter has really been a sleeper, good sleeper surprise here for the 6 a.m. match of the Norm Stewart Classic. Going to be a big quest for Quest Charter, down by 14, entering the final chapter. They cannot afford to turn it over. Good control there by Harvey. Oh, right as we said it, he lost it. And Gavin Bailey's the first in line at the bank this morning to cast a check.
Limited hours today, but he's getting his money's worth.
Hey, the ATM is always open. Except when my wife asks me for money. Just kidding. Well, Cam, has Kaufman built up enough of a buffer? If Quest goes on a run, I think that's the main question.
Well, if
they add to the buffer, McGee air ball, and a foul will put Jalen King at the line, or rather, Quincy Jones.
Well, I think, you know, this could be enough, but if you're Deron Wilson, you never think it's enough, right? I mean, you want to keep the foot on the gas pedal, but I think you also want to see what your team's made of down the stretch because, you know, what if this is a championship game, right? What if they're in an environment like this in Springfield for a state championship later this year and the team's making a big run? You got to find a way to continue to push.
Now, Cam, you talk about championship games and one team that was not able to close things out was John Calipari's Memphis Tigers against the Kansas Jayhawks in the 2008 national championship. If the Tigers could hit their free throws, they would have had the title. Talk about KU. That's the play call here for Deron Wilson's group. Of course, they're a fan favorite in Kansas City after winning the national championship last season.
Yeah, I'm always interested in what different coaches used to mask their play calls. You know, if KU's a play that Bill Self runs, or KU's a play that Roy Williams came up with. I always find it interesting to figure that out, but it's a secret for a reason. They don't want to give their hand away.
Well, we probably didn't help by making it known, but you know, it's why they have inbound plays called Indiana. Well, I've tried to figure out where the play call Wyoming comes from.
You've got Kentucky as well. They use that in some different sets. Usually in pregames, you'll see that a lot.
How about Omaha?
Yeah, I've only heard Peyton Manning ever say that.
out of the trap. Good find. Bailey tied up. And they'll tab the foul against Jaden Jenkins. That'll be his sixth, rather team's sixth. Man, talk about needing some coffee this morning, Cam. They swing it up top, Sims. Bouncer, Bailey, no good, rebound. Kaufman and Jones will bring it down. Jones walking the high wire, lost control, and Gator basketball.
If you keep giving them opportunities, they can continue to try to cut this lead. You know, we always talk about this, James. If you let a team stick around too long, they're going to make you pay for it.
Oh, my. Talk about charge of the light brigade there for Jaden Hassam. He had to go up against two players that were about 6-7 inches taller than he was. And meanwhile, a bench warning was, well, maybe not formally called against Ron, rather against Deron Wilson. Cam, to me, it sounds like he's chirping at his players.
Yeah, it didn't seem like he was talking to the referee as much as he was trying to get his players to be a little bit more locked in on the defensive side of the ball.
And maybe it's just more noticeable with how quiet it is here this morning. Quest is hanging in there. Just trailing by 11. If they get the three-point ball going, this one could get interesting. They will bring in Jalen King. And McGee from downtown knocks it in from 9th Street.
That might be the dagger there, James.
I don't know yet, Cam.
It just seemed like that shot had a lot of momentum behind it.
That's true, but here's an answer. Davion McClendon puts it in.
Look, I'm not saying it can't be done, but I think down 12 with less than 4 minutes to play, Coughlin's going to manage this the right way down the stretch.
Well, I'm glad I didn't watch the 2012 Border War with you when Marcus Denman went off with Mizzou down by 12, 3.5 to go in this building. Oh, what a find. Cash money for Jalen King off the feed from Hassam. Rather, that was off the feed from McGee. And once again, McClendon picks up the ringing phone and says, hold on, I got another two for you. At what point do you start fouling if you're Charter? Rather, Quest Charter.
Well, I think you got to start fouling after you get the next stop. You got to get a stop here.
There's the foul, but they could have saved two free throws had they fouled him before he went up. Well, we head to break with Kaufman on top of Quest Charter by 12. And we're about to close this one out of the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
We're all in the game in the fight against cancer.
Now we need you on the team.
With you, we will save more lives.
You don't have to be a coach to join Coaches versus Cancer.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes!
Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
So two shots for Jalen King at the stripe. 2.5 to go. And the first one misses. Good morning from Columbia. James Stanley with Cam Thomas. As we wrap up the 6 a.m. bout of the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic, we'll see here if Quest Charter has enough in the tank. Well, the free throw is going to help him out here. Sims tipped. Still on the ground. Possession picked up by McClendon. He has good ball control and eventually wins the battle over McGee. Three-pointer. High Karam picked up by Bailey. He is blocked. Package secured. And Mallett almost lost the marble ride.
Well, you don't want that to happen. But I think here is where you've got to start shooting it from beyond the arc. I mean, you know, the math has to start adding up here, and Quest is down big, less than 2 minutes to go.
On the left wing, Cannett. Mayor Burrows cuts the lead down to 11. But it's going to take some great three-point shooting to make the difference. Sims puts it in drive. Left hand, bank no good. Rebound, Bailey, block secured. Kaufman comes the other way thanks to King's defense. And now in stride, Mallett is fouled. Cam, I think Quest Charter's now running on fumes, but they got a full tank. Oh, no foul is called. It's a block for Sims. And now it's plucked out of the air by Burrows on the drive. The tip back swirls around down the cup. Cam, this is a 9-point game.
Yeah, they've got to get a couple stops here.
And good decision there by Derek McGee to call the timeout. 1 minute, 1 second remaining in the final chapter here between Kaufman and Quest. Stick with us after the game for our coaches interview, as well as we'll chat with the game MVP. You got to hand it to Quest. They've made this interesting down the final stretch.
Yeah, they have. And I think, you know, we said it at about the three-minute mark that it might be rolling to a close. And then here they come, kind of scratching and clawing away, and chomping at the bit to get back in this thing.
McGee will bring it across the timeline. And Quest gets the stop they needed. Or did they? Jump ball. Arrow is with the Knights.
That could have been dangerous if they didn't get those two hands on there and force a jump ball, because the Gators could have went out in transition and potentially hit a three.
Ron Ingram wants a timeout.
I think he's going to try to draw up his best 10-point play.
I know that doesn't exist, but you can draw up a perfect 2 or 3-point play. And if you're Ingram, it's got to be one that creates some opening down the lane for you. If it's Kaufman, I just would try to continue to corral defensively and utilize the speed that you have at the guard position to kind of play offense defense a little bit. You see the bigs for Kaufman are on the bench right now, so they're going smaller. I think that's because they expect the Gators to go a little bit quicker pace. So we'll see who they have in. Who Quest has in is not going to dictate what Kaufman does offensively. They're just going to go.
And go they will. Foul at the baseline. And really, Kaufman should be able to put this game on ice if they can make their free throws. Here's a second look at it. Looks like they'll get it from behind on Davion McClendon. The first one is up and through for McGee. Two for two that trip for McGee. Time is winding down here for Quest. They need a three-pointer. They need it badly. Too much hesitation from Burroughs. Foul on the floor. He's got to avoid giving Quest free opportunities at the line.
Well, you know, if you keep giving them this, they're going to keep cutting it down, and you may have an opportunity to make this a ball game down the stretch. I mean, I know there's not a lot of time on the clock, but here's the thing, James. If Quest is able to hit this second free throw, they jump the passing lane, maybe they get a three, you know, all of a sudden, we're talking about a two-possession game.
Well, this game gets more and more interesting as we see Israel Whitley heading to the line. These guys look tired, Cam. I know you and I are running on fumes.
Yeah, but I think, you know, when you have the adrenaline of being out on the floor, sometimes that will force you to keep the game top of mind and not really think and just keep playing. I think some of those guys are in that position right now.
Whitley off the bench, his first point of the game. And the second one goes down the drain. A little smile there from Coach Wilson. And Cam, it looks like we're going to be talking to him here in just a moment. Come on.
And what an incredible job he's done. You know, he tried to control the emotion throughout the game. But I think it's tough sometimes when you have a crew that is this young, and you're trying to do so much with him. He's done a really good job of kind of holding his emotions and realizing that he's got to give leeway to his team and allow them to execute, and that's exactly what they've done tonight.
That's going to be a much easier bus ride home for Kaufman than it will be for Quest Charter back to Peoria, Illinois, and that should do it. They'll let Whitley dribble it out, and Kaufman comes back to win it by 12. We'll have your player of the game as well as a chat with Deron Wilson when we return. This is the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic from Columbia, Missouri.
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Some of us participate on the sidelines.
And some on the court.
We're all in the game in the fight against cancer.
Now we need you on the team.
With you, we will save more lives.
You don't have to be a coach to join Coaches versus Cancer.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes! Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Well, I was welcoming you back to the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. James Stanley here with Cam Thomas and our MVP of the game, Quinton Jones. Quinton, walk us through your gameplay today, and how does it feel to head back to Kansas City with a little bit of hardware?
Well, I just came out to play. Any opponent, anybody lined up against me, I just want to dominate out through four quarters.
Now, your team down the stretch was able to close things out. We saw a little bit of back and forth in the first quarter. What was the difference between the first and second halves?
First half, I was just warming up. And then, you know, second half, I seen how they was playing, the defense they was in. So I just came from trying to I don't know how to put it. I'm excited. I don't know. I don't know what to talk about.
How tough was it, you know, coming and making the trip to Columbia, but being up and alert at 6 a.m. to be able to play a game and do all the things necessary to win?
Well, coming down here, it was like a 3.5-hour drive, so I just made sure I got enough rest throughout the night, got up early, came ready to play. I was excited to be down here.
Can you talk a little bit about the guard play tonight? I mean, you saw a lot of help that allowed you to have some success on the offensive end. Just talk about how your teammates were able to give you some support.
Well, our game plan was to, like, you know, pass the ball, make sure the ball don't stick in one spot. So they did a good job of that. And when they did that, then it opens up opportunities for everybody else on the court. So when they did that, then, you know, I got open. I made shots. Got shots to fall.
Well, Quinton, hope you have a safe trip back to Kansas City. And I think now we're going to turn things over to your head coach, Coach Deron Wilson.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for having me.
And congratulations. And as we get set here for head coach Deron Wilson.
Hey, how you doing?
Coach. How you doing, Coach?
And now we're joined by head coach Deron Wilson. As coach, your team got the job done. It showed a great amount of your team's ability to come back from being down in the first quarter to win by double figures in the second half.
Yeah. We talked about kind of regrouping at halftime and some things that we needed to improve on to give our chance a better opportunity to win in the second half. And they came out and responded. I'm proud of them. I think, you know, that 6 o'clock a.m. game, it takes them a little bit to get woken up. And they woke up in the second half, and I'm real proud of the way our guys responded.
Did they have any trouble adjusting to the depth of the range behind the basket? Because we've seen some teams struggle.
Yeah, we have. I think early on, the shots, I could tell that they weren't used to that. A couple of our top shooters shot a couple air balls, so I knew there that they wouldn't have used to the background yet. But as the game went along, they got more comfortable.
You know, it seemed like at certain points of the game, the intensity levels kind of went up and down, and I think that might be attributed to playing a game so early. But it seemed like you were able to keep your guys level-headed throughout the entire game. Can you just talk about their ability to be receptive to coaching throughout the ball game?
Yeah, I'm real proud of our guys. Like, they want to get better.
Right.
I think that's the main thing is our guys want to get better, and they're coachable, and they're taking the feedback from our coaching staff and then implementing that, what we're teaching them in practice and going over in huddles and stuff like that, implementing those things on the court and during the game. So that's what they were able to do today. And like I said, basketball is four quarters. You don't win a game in the first quarter or the second quarter. So maintain, stay level-headed, and keep doing the things that we've been working on to be successful.
Well, Coach, I think that's about all we have for you here. Thanks for joining us. Congratulations on the win. And we'll wrap things up here from the 6 a.m. match of the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. Up next will be Jim Powers and Joe Northern on the call for our next match in the 8 a.m. game. Stay tuned. You've been watching the 2022 Norm Stewart Classic. For my broadcast partner, Cam Thomas, this is James Stanley signing off, and we'll see you next year.
Hi, I am Special Olympics Missouri CEO Larry Linthicum, and this is my good friend Shiver Bear. It's time to get groovy.
Our disco-themed polar plunges are the perfect way to support Special Olympics Missouri. Choose from 10 funky and frigid bodies of water this January, February, and March. Proceeds support thousands of children and adults with intellectual disabilities throughout the Show Me State.
Yes!
Wait, where is Shiver Bear?
The American Cancer Society's Hope Lodge communities offer a free home away from home, closer to cancer care. People are meant to be together. Donate to help keep it that way.
Norm Stewart here, former basketball coach, University of Missouri. When you have a good player, you know you're going to have success. When you have a player that is also a leader, then what you try to do is just stay out of the way, and you really will be successful. That's what happened when Warner Baxter came into the fold and started with Coaches versus Cancer. From that, we went on to CEO versus Cancer. What a great ride it's been, and how many people he has helped along the way. I want to congratulate the St. Louis chapter of the American Cancer Society. All your help and the corporate leadership in that area has been tremendous. You've helped so many people. I think all of us always wonder, what can we do? It's very easy. Just do what you can do.